by one.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is a fatal four-way tag team match.
We're glad to have you here.
I'm glad to be here if I know the Brute Squad's going to be back in there.
Well, I think you're
scheduled for one fall.
Speak of the Devils.
Oh, boy.
Speaking of them boys.
Introducing first, making their way to the ring at a combined weight of 365 pounds from the Brute Squad Dojo, Mike Skylos and Jacoby Riddick, the Brute Squad.
I didn't realize it was hunting season already.
Disciples of the so effing big one himself. Brute brothers, Skyros and Riddick.
Clearly ready to put a hurtin' on somebody tonight.
Well, I'll tell you firsthand just how dangerous these two are. I mixed up with Jacoby Riddick and I wound up right here. I've mixed up with Skyros a couple of times. I tell you what, these two are dominant
athletes.
They're
the real deal, man. They're the real deal. You know, they train with right now with Brute, but train under Iced Effects as well, you know, like after the Institute of Pro Wrestling.
Introducing their opponents, the Takeover!
Formerly known as the Falcon Corps, Adam Falcon, Joe Quick, reinstated tonight by President Stanford, or else we face legal issues.
Take a look at those black masks, those featureless masks. It's as if they're abandoning their old identity and adopting this newer, darker persona. This is frightening sight.
They're incredibly off-putting, that's for damn sure. Especially with them stating what their mission is here, to change everything in Grand Slam Wrestling. I enjoy getting paid for what I do here. I don't want to do this for free.
I do too, yeah, I mean. I got it. I've heard this music in forever.
Introducing the next tag team. First, coming back to the ring from the Nintendo store, weighing in a combined weight, a collective 200 Pokeballs, the wrestling Pokemon fanatic, Andy Lee Ray, and his tag team partner from the ninth circle, the Juggernaut, Draconis.
What an incredibly strange matchup here.
Quite an eclectic pairing.
Strange bedfellows here at Moosic. ALR making his return to Moosic. I haven't seen him since late last year. And ominous by his, non-appearance, his bones at the side of Draconis.
What do you think Draconis' Pokemon collection looks like?
Wow, I mean, I don't know, man. Like, I'm sure it's like binders and binders and binders.
Do they have Pokemon that deep in hell? Hey, wait a minute now.
And finally, introducing their opponents. First, making his way to the ring from Jamaica, Queens, weighing in at 225 pounds, Mr. Cool Runnings, Tyrone Kid, and his tag team partner from the Pocono Mountains, weighing in at 218 pounds, Rex Taylor.
Rex Taylor making his GSW debut as well. And Tyrone Kid's never any in search to find a tag team partner.
I tell you what, I'm a little insulted that Tyrone Kid moved on from his old tag team partner so quickly. But I can tell you one thing. I've trained with Rex Taylor at Backbreakers Training Center. This man is a beast.
Well, he sure as hell looks it. Look at this guy. He's built like a...
Looking at him.
What
just
kind of house did
the
they say he's Brentleth?
The brick hit house.
There we go. There we go.
Brick what house?
Hit.
Oh, okay. Hit.
Eight bars. Mike Skyros in there starting this match off, looks like. Hey, Hilari held over to us. A Pokemon Ranger Demon. We're all to Professor Wrestling, you find this, and he's absolutely right. Look at these two jerks.
Brute Squad trying their best to get the crowd behind them, failing miserably.
Miserably, yeah.
I tell you what, the Brute Squad has an advantage a little bit in this match in the sense that they've been tagging together as recently. They have very good chemistry as a team that the other three teams may not have.
Absolutely, and even the Takeover, formerly the Falcon Corps, haven't been in GSW in a while, so they may have some ring rust of their own.
Exactly.
Max Taylor turned it off with Mike Skyros. The very impressive physique of Rex Taylor is on top of that shoulder block, taking him out.
Oh!
A big clothesline, Rex Taylor. Back elbow, taking one half of the Brute Squad down.
Whoa!
Big drop kick from Rex.
This is Lucha Tags here, folks. I should have mentioned that at the top of the match. One man out, another man comes in. This goes, keeps going.
Just the way I like it.
Fast and furious action, folks.
This is the clothesline.
Goes to O'Connell, nothing there.
Rex Taylor taking a knee to the face, jeez.
Winner of this match will end up being the number one contender for the GSW Tag Team titles.
That's right, Andy Lee Ray making his debut in the match.
Whoa!
And putting him down.
Andy Lee Ray, stronger than he looks. Do that much, folks.
You know, it might be easy to underestimate an athlete like Andy with his unique persona, his interesting hobbies. But this is a guy that can get it done in the ring. We've seen that a number of times.
His hobby, he's a Pokemon trainer. He's as good as Ash Ketchum in the ring.
Tyrone kick gets the
only
gets
a one.
Over. One count. Jackknife
in.
Kicks out.
Changing quick covers here.
Interesting small package.
Neither man able to get the advantage here. A wild exchange in the middle of the ring there. And both men being dragged out against their will. You know what that means?
Who's legal? What the heck has happened?
Draconis gets in, everybody gets out.
Everybody wants a place of these tag team titles.
Oh, dear, look at Draconis.
What's the demon doing?
Watch Draconis. Oh, boy. Everyone.
The demon, Draconis, lays them all out.
The demon takes flight and takes everyone out.
And would you look at this, the team that we commented on having the most unconventional matchup was the only one standing.
That's right.
Skyros begging out. Good God!
Jacoby lays it into the jaw of Andy Lee Ray. Skyros off the ropes.
She needs to get one of them out of here. I know that look. There's the headbutt.
Rock hard skull.
You know how hard
that skull
is. Let me
tell you what, I went into that match with the Brute Squad saying, how hard can the man's head be? You may notice I'm sitting here with you guys this week.
It's like solid rock the whole way
it's
through.
It's like stone. It's like getting hit with a cinder block. It's unbelievable.
Big double DDT here. Andy Lee Ray getting the advantage.
Both men roll out. That is definitely a tag. Adam Falcon in.
Rex Taylor, big jumping. Clothesline and a back elbow. Picks him up.
Wow.
Hoists him up.
That's a lot of power. And a TKO. Notice Joe's right behind him. No! Jesus!
Rex Taylor celebrating a little too early.
Rex in. This could be it.
Buries his feet in the breadbasket.
Takeover on their first night back. Excuse me, I'm sorry.
No, you're good.
Takeover on their first night back could be immediately number one contenders for the tag team championship. This could mean bad news for GSW.
Yeah. Well-placed kick. Oh, was that tag, maybe? He didn't, I don't know. Ah, maybe. Nah.
Oh, the team's getting
wow.
restless.
It was almost a bump rush in the ring. Did you see that?
Everybody was on Twitch for that two count.
First fall to a finish here, Moosic. Winner becomes tag team champion, number one contender for the tag team champions.
Ducks a clothesline off the ropes, ducks two clotheslines, both men at...
Double kick collision.
Both men thinking the same thing on that exchange.
Was not able to get out of the way on that one. Both men down, referee starting the count. Everyone reaching their hands out.
Any corner.
Almost any corner. Looks like both members of the Root Squad are on the ground.
TK back in.
Big spinning back elbow.
Tyrone Kidd is on fire.
Unbelievable athleticism of Tyrone Kidd.
Okay, looking for that. Oh, that's what is Skyros doing.
Minute, wait a minute.
Making the rounds.
Rex.
Huge pump kick.
Takes a boot himself. Oh, jeez.
Capture DDT.
Jacoby.
Oh, very nice.
Jacoby. Come in, but doesn't have the answer. Wait.
Draconis turns it around.
What is this?
Hooks the arm.
Ferris wheel suplex.
Goes to the pin. This could be it.
Takeover. Makes the save.
Both members of the Takeover shedding in there as quick as they could.
Oh, look at this.
Everyone piling on the big man.
Literally.
Again, the Griggs cleared again.
Ref CJ needs to find who is the legal man in this ring.
The unenviable task of keeping these eight men, these eight fired up men in order.
Yeah. Back to the ring, so quick. Tyrone Kidd.
Wait a minute, kids.
Oh, on the outside, Rex has laid out somebody. Couldn't see who it was. What's TK going for? Falcon!
Falcon disrupting the ref's count.
Breaking up the count by physically accosting the ref.
And ref CJ being very, very lenient with the rules here tonight. I mean, lucha rules are hard to keep in the street in general, but you know, one man in, one man out.
Difficult to even calculate a disqualification in a match like this, though.
Kind of a tag, I guess, to Joe Quick.
I've lost track a long time ago who's legal.
As far as I'm concerned, if you're in the ring, you're legal.
Oh!
Oh!
Oh, God!
Oh.
Wait a minute, what's Stamper doing out here?
Stamper seems to be taking issue with the Takeover.
The Brute Squad!
Brute Squad taking advantage of the Bedlam, kicking both members of the Takeover out.
Wait a minute.
Oh, no, Tyrone Kidd in there alone with Brute Squad.
Sizing up their prey now. TK, no idea what's going on.
No! Double Misaki!
Rolling him over! Jacoby with the pin! Oh,
Brute Squad! Number one contenders!
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of this contest, the Brute Squad!
So much raw talent and potential in that ring tonight, gentlemen. It's amazing that anyone came out on top.
Wow.
But those who did come out on top are none other than Brute Van Slyke's protégés. Skyros and Jacoby, the Brute Squad. No doubt to the delight of Brute Van Slyke himself.
Boy, this turns almost into something of a lose-lose situation for the future tag team champions.
The Demon Draconis scared the crap out of me. They ain't finished yet.
Beating incredible odds, these gentlemen come out on top.
Mike Skyros, what the man just said, it's steak dinner time.